뭐 해야 돼? 아씨, 막혔어. 여기 있구만.
Hey there, Oscar.
My functions do not permit me familiarity, Kate Walker. Even if you are my first and only passenger.
Me? Your passenger?
Yes, you, Kate Walker. Is it not for that reason you completed my production process?
If you say so. I can't wait to meet Hans Varlberg. What about you?
I would find the experience inordinately gratifying.
And I won't forget to congratulate him on the success of his incredible automaton.
Why, thank you, Kate Walker.
This train is amazing. I'm going to travel like a princess.
I am happy that you like it, Kate Walker. This train has been designed to optimize passenger comfort.
Poor Madame Varlberg. I'm sure she would have loved to come along.
This train was designed for only one passenger, Kate Walker.
So, it's like I've taken her seat.
아, 이 열차가 항스 그 만나러 가려고 만든 열차구나.
Oscar, if you were in my shoes right now, what would you do?
My reasoning mechanism does not permit me to manage problems outside the mandate of my own functioning.
Oscar, if you were in my shoes,
my reason
don't think
I also.
It's me again, Oscar.
Hello, Kate Walker.
I have decided to come along for the ride, Oscar. Ready when you are.
Your ticket, please.
My ticket? What are you talking about?
The rules clearly state, Kate Walker, every passenger of this train must possess a ticket.
Okay. And where do I get hold of a ticket?
Only the ticket vendor may issue tickets. You are in luck. The ticket office must be open now. You should go there immediately.
'It's you?
What can I do for you, madam?
But Oscar, it's me, Kate Walker.
Correct. Your name is indeed Kate Walker. What can I do for you, Kate Walker?
A train ticket, please. Why, do you sell anything else?
The only function of this ticket office is to issue tickets. You are requested to accelerate operations. The office closes in exactly 3 minutes. What can I do for you?
A ticket, please.
One ticket?
Yes.
One ticket. What is your final destination?
I don't know. It's you who told me I had to get a ticket.
A ticket to travel, then.
I 부동산이니까 공증 바꿔야 되구나, 인증 바꿔야 되구나.
There you are. Do not lose it. This office is not entitled to produce duplicates. This advice also applies to the accompanying documentation.
What's that?
The authorization for the release of the train. The ticket officer may ask you for it at any time.
But I mean, you are the...
Attention! The exact moment has arrived to close this office.
Kate, it's me again.
Dan, I was going to call you.
Yeah.
Are you mad at me?
I've just called Marston and Lorman. They told me you weren't expected to return this week.
Oh, yeah.
So when are you coming home?
I don't know. There's nothing I can do about it. The situation is kind of tricky, you know. At the beginning of next week, I hope.
Yeah, whenever.
Dan, please. Just hang in there, okay? The stakes are higher than I thought, and you know how much I love this job.
남자친구가 엄청 쫑쌤이네.
Here nor anywhere to you that the Goldbergs are going to...
It is. I mean, it isn't. I mean, Dan, this really isn't the moment. You know I'm thinking about you. I love you, sweetheart, and I'll give you a call when I have some news. Promise. I've got to go now. I've got kind of a train to catch.
A train? Where are you off to now? This is crazy, Kate.
To tell you the truth, I've no idea. Love you, honey. You know that.
Kate!
It's me again, Oscar.
Hello, Kate Walker.
Why aren't we setting off, Oscar?
I must abide by regulations. Your ticket, please, Kate Walker.
Don't think for one moment that I'm bored of you, Oscar, but I have to go.
I also have much to attend to, Kate Walker.
There you are, Oscar. Does this mean we can leave now?
I cannot accept this ticket for the moment, Kate Walker. Keep it.
Why don't you want to take my ticket?
I must abide by regulations, Kate Walker. Not all departure conditions have been fulfilled. I must confirm your departure release.
You can be a real stickler for the rules, Oscar, my old fellow. Here. This is the authorization for the release of the train.
It has not been signed, Kate Walker.
You're going too far. You just gave me this.
Does the train belong to you, Kate Walker?
No.
So there. This train cannot leave Aladdin without the agreement of its owner.
I don't think Madame Varlberg is in a position to sign anything right now.
In that case, the stamp of her legal representative is perfectly sufficient. Please hurry up, Kate Walker. This train will soon depart, and I must ensure it is not delayed.
아니, 해줘.
Oh, no. I forgot the notary will be resting.
잉크 없... 왜 잉크를 주나 했다 진짜. 잉크 없어서 안 된다는 말을 한마디 하든지. 아 진짜 게임 진짜 불친절하네 진짜. 아니 이거는 전통 어드벤처 게임입니다. 포인트 앤 클릭 방식의 전통 어드벤처 게임입니다.
'Here. This is your stupid train release ratification, Oscar.
Thank you, Kate Walker. That is perfect.
It's me again, Oscar.
Hello, Kate Walker.
This train is amazing.
I am...
Don't think for one moment that I'm bored of you, Oscar. But I
have
to go.
I also have much to attend to, Kate Walker.
It's me again, Oscar.
Hello, Kate Walker.
Why aren't we setting off, Oscar?
I must abide by regulations. Your ticket, please, Kate Walker.
와, 아까 보여줬잖아, 진짜.
Don't think.
I also.
There you are, Oscar. Does this mean we can leave now?
I cannot accept this ticket for the moment, Kate Walker. Keep it.
I don't understand why we can't leave. I'd hate to think it's me that's delaying the train like this.
아, 또 뭐야?
I do not wish to appear impolite, Kate Walker, but I am afraid that not all departure conditions have been fulfilled.
If that's a joke, Oscar, it's not very funny. I really need to find Hans Vorarlberg as quickly as possible.
I have strict instructions to obey. There are three spaces in the luggage compartment that are designed to accommodate two very important objects. The train can only depart when they are in place. Please excuse me now. I must return to my departure preparations.
Oh, I wouldn't want to break any rules. These shelves look as if they're made for valuable objects. These shelves look as if they're made for valuable objects. And if I were to watch one of those cylinders again... Right. Everything is in order then. The train is finally ready to leave.
I am most terribly embarrassed. Such ignorance on my part is inadmissible. I hope you still have confidence in my abilities, Kate Walker. Please return to your seat and we can leave.
Finally. Where are we, Oscar?
At the halls of residence of Barockstadt University.
And do we really have to stop here?
The situation is incompatible with the pursuit of our journey.
What are you waiting for, then? Wind them up. Find a way. There must be some sort of train-winding thing just laying around in this weirdo station.
I have seen nothing that fits that description, Kate Walker.
I guess we'd better find out, then.
I do not like this station. The atmospheric humidity is detrimental to my sophisticated wheel workings. I will wait for you inside the train.
Wimp. This train might be a wonder of technology, but the engine's limited autonomy is a liability. You got to admit that.
I am afraid I refuse to entertain this consideration, Kate Walker.
Oscar? There's no way you could help me find a way to wind the train back up again?
Rust awaits my every movement if I leave this train, Kate Walker. And what would you do with a rusty engine driver?
Not a lot, I suppose. Oscar, we have a serious problem. How can we carry on our journey if this train doesn't want to budge? What are our options?
Every clock has its key, Kate Walker. Keep looking.
Well, I hope you're right.
막불에 멍다 쓴 게 진짜 대단하다 진짜.
Oscar, see you later, alligator.
In a while, Kate Walker.
예, 돈 주고 타는 것보다 이런 태엽 열차를 탈 필요가 없죠.
혹시 모르니까 제가 좀 할게요.
Thing looks like the winding machine I used in the Valadilen station. I've got to find a way of getting the train up here.
There it is. There. There. How to go there?
I like this kind of adventure game. Hint 따위 없어. 아. 아 이거 어떻게 했더라? 아 기억이 하나도 안 나. 거기 그냥 가만히 있지, 씨. 이러면 또 뭐야.
Yes, Oscar. What is it?
A message has arrived for you.
A message?
You have been summoned to see the rectors. They are the highest authority at the university. They want to talk to you.
Talk to me?
Yes, to the person responsible for the train.
So, I'm in charge now. Sure, okay. But why would these gentlemen want to see me at all?
They do not say why, just that it's very important.
옛날 게임이에요. 다행히 시점이 이상하죠.
헬로.
Hey, baby, you party? You sure looking mighty fine. Love those big round eyes.
Just who do you think you are?
Hey, Spunky, I like that in a lady. Okay, I'm hooked. Come on, Zal. I'll let you buy me that coffee.
I don't remember ever asking.
Hey, don't play hard to get. I know you like it big time.
Listen, kid. Go back home and play with your toy cars and forget you ever saw me. Excuse me. Can I disturb you a second?
No.
You could be a little bit nicer about it.
Keep quiet. In case you haven't noticed, we're somewhere that requires silence and tranquility.
Good day to you, gentlemen.
Tell me, young lady, to what do we owe this pleasure?
Please do be brief. We do not have very much time on our hands.
As rectors of this university, we have serious matters to attend to, and our time is precious.
I have heard you wish to meet the owner of the train that is currently in your station. May I know the reason for your summons?
We are surprised that your train has not yet left, miss. The situation is most regrettable.
The rules do clearly state that trains are meant to come and go and not remain stationary at a platform.
Trains should first stop, then subsequently leave. That is the rule.
We agree then, dear colleagues, that what we're dealing with is deviant behavior.
This matter really is cause for concern.
It's a clockwork train, you see? So it needs winding up again? Unfortunately, there is no equipment in the station to do this.
A clockwork train? That's strange.
How very quaint. You mean it's some sort of mechanical toy?
You are causing a hindrance to us, miss.
I am very hopeful that I will find what I need along the wall.
The wall?
Miss, that really is not a suitable place for you to go.
Especially for a young lady.
You see, miss, we freely admit that every day we praise the existence of that particular edifice. We owe the integrity of our dear university and the fine education it provides to the wall.
It protects us from harm and invasion from the unknown.
May God protect us from what is beyond those ramparts, miss. Please believe me.
I don't have any choice. I must continue my journey.
Such a decision is a correct one, since it's in line with regulations.
Thus, your train will indeed be able to leave.
And consequently cease to obstruct our station.
That idea of the station aviary is really very original.
It's the pride of our university. One of the specialties taught here is zoology, you see, and more particularly, ornithology. Proper study and instruction should not be limited to books. Observation of living matter is indissociable from theoretical questions.
It contains some very rare specimens that have been brought back from faraway, exotic countries, especially for our university, by the world's most intrepid explorers.
Do you remember Alexander Valenbois and his peculiar bird?
Absolutely. His gift produced some very embarrassing long-term consequences.
A poison chalice, indeed. It must be said, the situation could have been much worse, however.
Oh, yes, it could have been terribly problematic.
Does the name Hans Vorarlberg mean anything to you by chance?
Ah, one of the brightest, most idealistic intellects to have graced our university. Hans Vorarlberg. I remember speaking to him once. I was still a student at the time. He just stared at me, lost in thought for a while. He scarcely ever said a word. But how can one forget him?
Idealistic? I'll grant you that. But bright? Oh, don't go too far. He was completely incapable of passing any exams. All he ever did was to sit in on lessons, and not many of them either. Paleontology, mainly. He had an unhealthy passion for mammoths, which matched the state of his intellect perfectly. That is to say, prehistoric.
Prehistoric? How dare you? A little far-fetched, maybe. But he did have flashes of intellectual brilliance, comprehensible only to high-minded scholars who hold no score by appearances. My dear colleague, your hasty conclusions are somewhat cavalier.
My assessment is wholly accurate. The boy was a little odd. You must concur, if my father, who was rector of the university at the time, had not shown great indulgence towards him, Hans Vorarlberg would have never attended this establishment.
What about the bandstand, then? Is that the work of a deranged mind? Even after all these years, you are still jealous of it.
My dear colleagues, I beseech you, let's show some decorum. We have a visitor. What do you want with Hans Vorarlberg, miss? Are you a member of his family?
No, not at all. I'm looking for him to clear up an inheritance matter. Is he still here?
What? Here? At the university? No, not at all. He left a long time ago. Yes, a very long time ago.
The
very year I was nominated to this position, in fact. Almost 50 years ago already.
The poor soul moved on once he learned all he needed to know about mammoths.
Ah, this establishment was never quite the same after his departure, it must be said.
You mean to say it was never as bad? All that oddball brought to this university was his misplaced fantasies!
Gentlemen, let's try to retain the calm and level-headedness that befits our position.
You see, I didn't actually intend to stop here, but the springs of my train gave up, you see?
No, not really. You mean to say you're not a student?
You have arrived a little late in the term, miss. Enrollment for this year has already terminated.
But as rectors of this university, and therefore representatives of its highest authority, we could bend the rules a little, if you like.
You don't understand. I'm a lawyer from New York, or rather Valedilene, more precisely. My client wants to buy out an old mechanical toy factory, but its heir isn't actually dead and is living somewhere in Siberia. I've got to get to him to sign the sales contract. You see?
Not really. This is a most peculiar tale.
A kerfuffle of the highest order.
We have an excellent law school, if you should ever change your mind.
Can you possibly help me out here?
Miss, your insistence is almost verging on indecency.
We cannot constantly be at your disposal. We have many other requests to attend to.
If you don't mind, could you not disturb us all the time? Thank you.
Here we are, busy chat-chatting, and look at the clock. It's tea time.
Already? My word, doesn't time fly by?
Thank you for a charming visit, miss.
And thank you, gentlemen.
그래서 무슨 책을 얻었던 걸로 기억하는데 기억이 잘 안 납니다. 결국 이 포도 얻어야 된다. 안전 100% 한글화 됐고요. 한글화가 완벽하게 됐기 때문에 플레이하는 데는 별 부담이 없습니다.
'Excuse me. Sir, please, just a moment.
Yes, what is it? I'm not deaf, you know.
I am sorry to disturb you in your work, sir, but...
This young Mammothus primigenius is barely 40,000 years old. Fantastic, wouldn't you say, miss?
Yes, probably.
What do you mean, probably?
I don't know.
You don't know? Well, you don't know, I see. What can I do for you, my dear child?
If I were to say Forest Sauvignon to you, what would you say?
Oh, let's see. Sauvignon? I would say it's some kind of tropical shrub, don't you think?
We are talking about the same plant, then. It is a very rare shrub with small, juicy fruits. I found a book about the Amazon, and it says that there are even Sauvignon plants growing right here in Bergstadt. You wouldn't know where, would you?
Amazon Sauvignon plants here? No. No, I don't think there are any. Highly implausible. But you should ask the station master. He is keeper of the greenhouse at our university, so he could tell you more than me.
Oh, thanks very much. My train stopped in a peculiar aviary. It's very odd. A lot of bird species seem to seek harbor there.
Ornithology is far from being my favorite subject, but I must concede that the station is the pride of the university. It was initially intended for teaching purposes, but then birds started arriving from all around the world. It seems that there are still rare species breeding there and flourishing.
Are there? Can you give me an example?
I have been told about a kind of bird with peculiar habits. Let's see now, the Amazon cuckoo, that's right. But, I'm so foolish, I can't remember what was so special about it. Just that its behavior is very peculiar.
The Amazon? Where's the Amazon? What is the Amazon?
I'm sorry, my dear, but one cannot learn everything in a lifetime. Specialization is the key to real knowledge. Why don't you pay a visit to our library?
Thank you very much. To tell you the truth, I'm looking for Mr. Hans Vorarlberg. He's the sole heir of a very unusual factory. My company is in charge of negotiations for the takeover of this factory. At last word, he was living in Siberia. So, as soon as my train is ready, I'll be continuing my journey eastwards.
Siberia... Ah, Siberia. But what was it you said again?
Said what?
You mentioned a name. The person you are looking for.
Vorarlberg. Hans Vorarlberg. Do you know him?
Hans Vorarlberg. How could I forget him? Such an extraordinary fellow. So inventive. We shared a passion for mammoths, you know, and we bonded over this passion. Without it, I confess, I would have had little to do with an odd, ageless retard like Hans. At the time, we were both students. Well, sort of. Put it this way. Hans had special permission to attend paleontology lectures. You see, he didn't really have the necessary qualifications. In exchange, Hans did a few odd jobs around the university.
Your Hans Vorarlberg sounds uncannily like the one I'm looking for.
I'm not sure, my dear. Hans was above all questions of money and business. Just to imagine him running a factory, perish the thought.
Can you tell me a little bit more about him?
He was always a mystery to me. He never said very much, and never quite seemed to grasp what you said to him. He expressed himself instead through his incredible mechanical contraptions. His inventions, I admit, have been much appreciated by the university. The few times we really did talk, it was about his strange interest for mammoths and a doll. Some sort of doll that obsessed him.
A doll, you say?
Yes. He kept talking about it.
One day he described it to me.
A sort of children's toy. A miniature mammoth mounted by a mount. It appears he found it in a cave not far from his home. The event all sounds very dramatic. His account was slightly confused, but it awoke a great interest in me.
What do you mean?
To my knowledge, there was only one tribe who made figurines featuring a mount, and that tribe is the Yukols. They live in the farthest reaches of Siberia, and for them, the dolls constituted a sacred object, illustrating one of their central legends, how such a doll made the journey from the frozen Siberian north to a cave in the French Alps is a mystery to me. Even today, it is beyond my comprehension.
Have you considered that Hans Vorarlberg was maybe making it up? You said yourself he didn't seem to have all his mental facilities intact.
No, that's impossible. Hans couldn't invent the story like that. The doll is a sacred part of the Siberia legend. He described it to me in exact detail. Siberia itself is a chimera that paleontologists of the world are very fond of pursuing.
What would you say about seeing Hans Vorarlberg again? After all, you could come with me and help me find him.
Young lady, you are very kind. I'm far too old for such escapades.
Please do excuse my persistence, Professor, but did Hans Vorarlberg ever talk about his childhood? About Valadilen and his sister, Anna?
No, not that I recall.
Pity.
When I think of Hans, I'm always reminded of a mysterious mammoth doll he would talk about so often. A small effigy of a mammoth made of hide and mounted with its own miniature mount. How come he was so lucky? Why have I not seen this?
I'll leave you in peace. I hope I haven't disturbed you too much.
Sorry? No, not at all, my dear child.
Hello?
So, you got him then, this air?
Ah, it's you, Mr. Marson. Good day, and how are you, sir?
I'll feel a whole lot better when this whole business is over and the sales contract is signed. Where the hell are you?
I'm in Bergstadt.
What? What in God's name are you doing there?
It's a magnificent university town. It would appear Hans Vorarlberg once passed by here several years ago.
So if he isn't there anymore, then there's no point hanging around.
I hear what you're saying, sir, but I have good reason to believe that Hans Vorarlberg is still alive. For the time being, I'm trying to gather extra information from people who have known him.
근데 이 여자는 판정도 아니고 법정 대리인인데 무슨
exactly
하는 짓을
하냐,
뭔 거야?
Doesn't sound like you know too much, Kate.
I just need a bit of time, Mr. Morrison.
Yeah, well, time is what you ain't got. Keep me posted.
네, 뭐라고요? 여기로 가는 건가? 기억이 안 나. 원래 전통 어드벤처 게임은 이래요. 이 아저씨가 역장 같진 않고.
헤이 there. On the boat.
나가 잘 생겼던데.
Good talk, sir, mademoiselle.
My husband say, "Hello, young lady." You want to talk to us?
It must be really neat to travel by river.
Oh, stick the boot. I never forget that's grund. For me, loco is fantastic. And a kleiner road met usted. Okay, you guide.
Excuse me? My husband say he like his barge and he not like your train. Too noisy. If you want to travel in tin can, you stay in tin can.
Sure. I have a little problem with my train. It's kind of broken. I've absolutely got to get it out of the station. Do you think you could tow it over to the wall with your barge?
Lock closed. Barge block.
아, 맞다, 이,
But if the locks
배가,
were open, would it be okay to tow my train then?
Por qué no? More money for that work.
Ah, it's possible. My husband say we help you if you give money.
Right. And how much do you want?
50.
He want $150.
$150? I don't have that much.
No money, no bar.
Let me offer you 75.
Nay, $125.
Out of the question. $100 and not a dime more.
Correct. You have barge for $100.
Great. Now, don't move. I'll be back as quick as possible with the money. I'll leave you to it. I won't disturb you again.
돈도
없어.
돈도 없잖아. 한 푼도. 왜 안 올라가?
헬로.
You arrived by train, I see.
Yes, I've come from Valladolid.
It's been a long time since I've seen a train here. Students, did you bring students with you?
No, I traveled alone. Well, almost alone.
I remember around the start of fall, trains would bring kids from all around the world here to study zoology and botany, paleontology, and all that stuff. This was a great university.
And it isn't still great today, then?
Today,
The sailors on the barge reckon they could help me tow my train out of here, but they're asking for money. You couldn't possibly help me out with a few dollars, could you? I would be very grateful.
Miss, really, I'm surprised at you. Asking for money from a total stranger.
Right. I need cash. I need it to get my train out of your station, because my train is getting in your way, disturbing your birds, and upsetting your bosses.
Look, lady, I'm only a station master. I got my problems, and you got yours.
Where might I find some forest Sauvignon plants, please?
No place around here, that's for sure. I don't know what you're talking about. That stuff's from the Amazon.
You know, for someone who knows nothing about the plant, you seem pretty well informed about which mysterious faraway country it comes from.
Oh, Amazon, Peru, Papua New Guinea, it's all the same to me. Gotta go. Gotta work.
Wait, don't go. You know what? I don't think he was being totally straight with me.
원래 전통 어드벤처 게임은 대화가 많습니다.
'Excuse me, station master, but I need you again.
Can't you see I am very, very busy?
No.
Well, I am. Very busy indeed. But, okay. I think I can give you a minute of my time.
I'm looking for a kind of little juicy berry. You don't know where I could find some?
Look, lady, the station doesn't have any Sauvignon berries, not even forest Sauvignon.
Funny you should mention it. That's exactly what I was looking for. Forest Sauvignon.
Sauvignon, raspberries, red currants, they're all the same to me. And we don't grow none of them here.
But you see, I have just read a very interesting book, which says that the rare Sauvignon berry is actually cultivated here, in the famous Baruchstadt University aviary itself.
Well, if it's in a book, then don't believe everything you read, miss.
I don't know why, but I don't think you're telling me the truth.
What do you mean? I don't know. How should I know where to find your stupid grave? Go ask your professor, what's-his-name, Pons, the paleontologist.
But you're the master of this station, so you should know better than anyone.
Nobody tells me anything. I don't know. Go see the old guy with the fossils.
I won't disturb you any longer, Mr. Station Master.
Welcome to Baruchstadt, miss.
무슨 여기 있다고요, 진짜.
do excuse me, Professor. Professor, sorry to disturb you again. Professor, I have brought you something that should be of interest to you. Look.
What have you got there, Venner? Let's see. An effigy of a mammoth. But this is Hans Dahl, is it not? Yes, of course it is. How on earth did you... Oh, my God. It's in my hands. It exists. It really exists. Please, please do excuse me. I'm deeply, deeply moved.
You see? Your Hans and my Varlberg heir are one and the same.
This is incredible. After all these years, how can I ever thank you, my dear? Oh, I must waste no time. I'm off to my laboratory. I must study this carefully. May I borrow your treasure a moment? Don't worry, miss. I will take the greatest care of it. But I need to study it. You see, it has such importance to me that this very afternoon I shall deliver an impromptu lecture to my students about this very object. If you are interested in Hans Vorarlberg, then it is essential that you attend.
Do you think so?
Obviously. Give me your telephone number and I will call you the moment my lecture begins. I will return you your doll at the end. You have my word.
I don't need that for the time being.
What is it you want to know, miss?
You wouldn't know where the forest Sauvignon plants are kept in Bauerkstadt, would you?
Why do you think there are Sauvignon plants here?
I read about it in a book at the library.
Try going to see the station master. If such a shrub exists, he will have a better idea than anyone.
It's actually he who sent me to you. I thought it a little strange, but he definitely said ask the paleontologist. You're the only one here, aren't you?
Yes, yes indeed. What a strange way to behave. Well, I think he must have made a mistake, that's all. Nobody tells me anything here, then maybe you should ask the rectors. After all, they are in charge of the university.
All right, thanks. I'll leave you in peace. I hope I haven't disturbed you too much.
Sorry? No, 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 not at all, my dear child.
자, 앙코라 가루는 나중에 뭐 할 때 쓰는 걸로 기억하는데 아마 무슨 경비병인가? 건강할 때 썼던 걸로 기억하는데?
'Gentlemen, forgive me for disturbing you again, but I have a little problem.'
A little problem, a little problem. Everyone has little problems now, you know.
They are kept to oneself, and they don't stop the world from turning.
Nor trains from leaving stations.
Are you sure there are no Amazon Sauvignon plants in Barockstadt? Because I have just interviewed the station master and the paleontologist, and what they said really didn't convince me that there wasn't any here.
We are quite definite on this point. There are no Sauvignon plants growing in Barockstadt.
You see, miss, the Amazon Forest Sauvignon is a rare shrub that requires very special conditions for growth.
That's right. Conditions that are very hard to reproduce, believe you me.
Difficult, but not impossible. Fortunately, our garden has proved very successful.
Your garden? So, there is a garden in Barockstadt?
Oh, the garden. Well, if there was one, it would be only a little garden hidden behind the station. But our station master would be very proud of it.
He would take very good care of it, too. Everything would grow marvelously if we were able to cultivate it at all, and it would be all down to his gardening prowess.
And we would be proud as punch. And we wouldn't forget the role the paleontologist might play in this.
What's the paleontologist got to do with it all?
Without him and without his laboratory, how would we make the wine, do you think?
And it would be good wine indeed, my dear colleagues.
Would it not?
Oh, yes, a delightful balm to soothe away our long hours of toil and our heavy responsibilities.
We would wait impatiently every year for the arrival of the year's produce.
So, if I have understood you correctly, there are indeed Sauvignon plants in Barockstadt. They are cultivated in a garden behind the station, then turned into wine by the paleontologist's loving care. And finally, the pleasure of tasting is yours.
실수로 했어, 범죄에 대해서.
If I'm not very much mistaken, gentlemen, you have a minor racket operating here.
Miss, you do go jumping to some hasty conclusions.
We never said that. That's not what we said at all.
We were talking in the conditional. You know, with ifs and woulds.
So, what would happen if I had such a hunch?
You would have to keep it to yourself, of course.
Yes, if you would be so kind as to keep it a secret. It would only be a small local concern, producing barely a few bottles every year.
That's right, nothing so grandiose as a business. Otherwise, you'd be liable to be fined.
So,
we can't count on your discretion, can't we?
Don't worry, I have no intention at all of getting messed up in anything. Some sailors have agreed to tow the train, but I don't have enough money to pay them. I was wondering if you could help me out. For a while. I could work for the money.
Please wait, miss. We have certain confibulations to attend to.
That is right. We must confibulate between ourselves. A collegiate decision must be taken.
I hope that we are not indisposing you in any way.
Why not?
If it helps us get rid of that train.
My word, that is a fine idea.
What do you have in mind, gentlemen?
When you arrived here, you must have noticed a splendid bandstand which honors the main university courtyard.
A unique piece of mechanical craftsmanship which no longer works, alas.
Why, yes, we have very moving memories of its melodies. We're prepared to offer you a financial reward if you can set it working again.
With pleasure. What do I have to do?
Unfortunately, my dear, time and rust have taken their toll on this university, and our automatons no longer have a spring in their step. You are going to have to be resourceful.
To tell you the truth, there are a number of complex mechanisms here in Barockstadt, and it would appear that we have unfortunately lost their operating instructions.
Your train, however, is an extremely ingenious invention, so you should be no stranger to complex mechanisms. We are therefore counting on your ingenuity, miss.
I hope that I can show myself worthy of your faith in me, gentlemen.
Well, my dear colleagues, one more university matter nicely tied up.
Here we are, busy chat-chatting, and look at the clock. It's tea time.
Already? My word, doesn't time fly by.
Thank you for a charming visit, miss.
And thank you, gentlemen.
이것도 힘들다. 왜 내가 한 게임은 다 이렇게 어렵냐? 새 알이 보이니까 역시 결국은 새 알 구하러 가야 되는 거 아니에요? 예전에 새 알 구하다가 무슨 문제 생겼던 건지 한번 해보긴 하자.
Excuse me, Station Master, but I need you again.
Can't you see I am very, very busy?
No.
Well, I am. Very busy indeed. But, okay, I think I can give you a minute of my time.
You have been playing with me, haven't you? You knew very well there were forest Sauvignon berries in the station garden.
No, not at all. I've never seen your Sauvignon things.
You don't have to lie to me. I know all about it. You and the rectors are in cahoots, and the professor's lab has been turned into a distillery. You've all got a nice little smuggling racket on the side.
Smuggling racket? Hey, lady, you're going a bit far there. It's just a little on-the-side thing we got going, that's all. It's just for ourselves. Hey, be honest.
You should be ashamed of yourselves. Aren't you worried about the reputation of this fine university? The authorities should be informed.
But we haven't done anything wrong. We've started a crime.
Can you open the gate to the garden, please?
Sure. No problemo. Right away, miss. Please feel free to visit the garden at your leisure. And there was just one thing. I'm not a liar. Not really. Just mum's the word. There is the reputation in the university to think about, and I have superiors, and I have to do what I can.
I understand. Don't you worry.
Oh, thank you, miss.
개냐? 개야? 먹을 거 주기가 바로 뽀로로 가네. 참 바로 앞에 있는데 손 안 닿는다는 게 지금 말이 안 되긴 하지만 여러분. 힘들다. 이 게임도 어려운 게임이었어, 생각보다.
A shadow of himself since your departure. I had to take care of everything for him. Housework, factory paperwork, the workforce, clients, everything. And now, today, well, I really don't know who or what I'm fighting for. Times are so hard, and this terrible war is destroying everything. Nobody cares for our automatons anymore. I just think about you returning. And when you do return, I will have turned this factory into a palace worthy of your genius. Please take care of yourself. I love you so much, Anna.
Oh, 진짜 힘들다.
Miss, please, excuse me.
Yes?
You know, I want to apologize for our little misunderstanding. I brought you a bottle of wine. Barrichstadt Sauvignon. Very good here. Let me know what you think.
I'm very touched. Thank you.
Good luck on your journey, lady.
Thank you.
왔지. 아, 또 들어가 뻔해. 고치는 거 엄청 간단한데? 이거 못 고쳤어? 이거 고쳤으니까 얘 좀 받을 수 있겠죠.
Gentlemen, forgive me for disturbing you again, but I have a little problem.
A little problem, a little problem. Everyone has little problems now, you know.
They are kept to oneself, and they don't stop the world from turning.
Nor trains from leaving stations.
Gentlemen, I have managed to repair your university bandstand.
The bandstand is playing again. This is marvelous news.
We are really very grateful indeed.
Yes, very grateful indeed. We will look back on your visit with much fondness in our hearts.
And now let us in turn honor our word. How much is it you need, miss?
$100, if it's not too much to ask.
Something like that.
We agreed to grant you the aforementioned sum, miss. You may now leave with your train.
And while we're on the subject, when will you be leaving?
Yes, because now you should relocate your train as quickly as possible. Here we are, busy chat-chatting, and look at the clock. It's tea time.
Already? My word, doesn't time fly by.
Thank you for a charming visit, miss.
And thank you, gentlemen.
'80년대의 어드벤처 게임은 1980년대, 그러니까 80년대 후반 이후로는 거의 나오지 않았습니다. 왜냐면 어드벤처 게임이 무리하고 그 이후로 이런 전통 어드벤처 게임은 안 나왔는데 이 사이베리아가 2000년대 초반에 나와서 한창 사람들 사이에서 폭풍을 가한 어드벤처 팬들 사이에서는 꽤 명작이라고 불리는 게 명작이 꽤 어드벤처 팬 사이에서는 꽤 명작이라 불릴 수 있는 게임이 나왔죠. 그러니까 과거의 핵이죠. 과거의 핵. 이거 성공했고. 그래서 2하고 이번에 3가 나오고. 이제 3가 나올 줄 진짜 몰랐습니다. 아우, 혀가 꼬인다. 혀가 꼬여. 여튼 엄청 오래된 게임 하고 있는 거예요, 저는. 지금 나온 지 벌써 14년 된 게임입니다.
There you go. Here's your money. I've checked it. It's all there. Ah, thank you. Not difficult to get dollar. See? You are a real businesswoman. I'm not the only one around here. We pleased to do deal with you. Now, you open lock or we no help you. Why didn't you manage to open them? After all, you don't have to be a genius.
Ma vor vat pensiro sesto? Di kleina madam.
Fasso.
No se sei mara alles non comprendo. En allora caput in andere bordel. Vir svar moi. On bum telefonieren caput caput.
My husband say instructions complicated. No understand manual. My husband angry. Very angry. Oh, now telephone broke. Kaput.
Now that is annoying. What are you going to do next?
We wait repairman.
Well, I don't have the time to wait. I'll have to go have a look. There must be some way of releasing the opening mechanism.
Take key. Sailor always need key for lock.
Okay,
thanks. Hello?
Hey, how's my little baby girl? I was thinking about you only
yesterday.
Fantastic fur coat. You are wrapping up warm, aren't you? I mean, people in foreign countries never know how to dress properly for the weather.
Mom, it's so sweet of you to worry, but I'm fine, really. The trip's a breeze, no worries. I mean, there's...
Well, when are you coming back? Frank is dying to meet you.
Frank? Oh, yeah, your singer. You two seeing each other then?
Oh, you'll never guess the surprise he gave me yesterday.
No, I suppose I won't.
Frank invited me to a big charity show organized by, someone or another. Anyway, they got him singing a couple of old numbers from his repertoire, and in the end, he asked me to go up on stage with him. Can you imagine me, your mother, on stage in front of thousands of people?
Wow, I would have loved to have been there. Not too emotional, I hope.
Oh, too emotional by far, especially as I hadn't even been to the hairdresser. Well, I didn't even have the proper dress on. But Frank promised me he'd see to that next time. Oh, he's such a cutie, and he's got the sweetest little...
I'm sure he has, Mom.
It would be so good if you could join us one day. Let's see, when is his next gala? I'm so forgetful these days, I swear I'd lose my head if it weren't in the clouds. You just watch out, my girl. Them years will catch up with you much quicker than anything.
I'll look out for them. Nice to hear your voice. Lots of love.
출애하는데도 시간이 세상 걸렸어. 만약 길 몰랐으면 난리 날 뻔했네, 진짜. 이것도 쉬운 게임이죠.
Broken.
Ah, 이놈의 기억력이 진짜.
요 컴비네이션 넘버 is not valid.
이거보다 투네더가 더 어려워요.
If you want to raise the water level, press 1. If you want to lower the water level, press 2. To return to the last command, press the number sign. You want to lower the water level in the barrage.lock? To confirm your choice, press star. To return to the previous command, press the number sign. Your request has been logged. Unfortunately, our regional technician is currently on holiday, and no replacement is available. We will reply to your request within 48 hours. In case of an emergency,
와,
please
대박.
Operate the lock system 대박. Manually. We apologize for delays to our service.
대충 이런 거 같더라.
셔너 마드모셀.
My husband say, "Hello, young lady. You want to talk to us?"
Right. I've got it. I know now how the locks work. So guide your boat into the lock, and I'll take care of the mechanism.
Gott verdammt! Das ist eine echte Ladies. Alle toi, range alle Dingen und obligados die Dame. Ach, seid content und zurück again.
What did your husband say?
You, hurry up. We hurry to travel again.
Okay, okay. We'll meet each other on the other side. By my train, okay?
Oh, 꽤 귀찮아, 진짜. 옛날 방식이야. 아, 여기도 끝이 보인다. 어!
Hey there. On the boat.
Da, da, barge on other side. You still need us?
It must be really neat to travel by river.
Oh, steck the boat. I don't forget that screw.
Excuse me, my
Das wieder.
Hey there. On the boat.
Da, da, barge on other side. You still need us?
What do we do now to tie my train to the barge?
Mademoiselle Takatak, loco coco mitchen.
What did your husband say?
You attach chain to train and chain put train with barge.
Hop! Catch us up.
That's going to work. Looks like something's missing.
같이 주셨던 갈고리 사용하면 되겠지. なま 예전에 한번 했었는지 안 했으면 와, 진짜 끔찍하다. 진짜.
Hello, Kate Walker here.
Miss Walker, this is Professor Ponce. I'm about to start my lecture on the Euclid at any moment. Please make haste to come.
Okay, I'll give it my best.
Excellent. We'll be in the main lecture hall. See you soon.
핸드폰 번호 또 언제 교환했대?
Ah, there you are, Miss Walker. Good, good. Take a seat quickly. I'm impatient.
엄청 지루한 간과 씨앗 될 것 같다.
My young friends, a very exciting discovery, unimaginable up until only a few hours ago, has come into my hands and has finally allowed me to complete my study on the mysterious Yukol people. Lights, please. The Yukols are a people from the far north about whom very little is known. They live far away, very far away, on the frozen borders of Siberia. This distance and the climatic conditions of the region, which are unfavorable,
have sized
the Yukol population and kept it out of reach of the scientific world. The handful of slides that follow are actually the only documentation we have in our possession. It was a Russian explorer who made these drawings and took these photographs 100 or so years ago. Today, we owe what we know about the Yukol people and their culture to him. We know that the origins of the Yukols date back to the last ice age. Curiously, evidence of their presence has been found in Western Europe, and more precisely in the prehistoric caves at the heart of the Alps. This people, it seems, undertook a long migration over centuries towards the far north of the globe. The reasons for this migration are due to the importance of the mammoth in their craft, trade, and culture. They used them for transportation and as beasts of burden. The mammoth brought them meat, skins, fat, and ivory. Man and animal lived in symbiosis. There's no doubt about it. Mammoths started to drift away from the region due to changing climatic conditions, and the Yukols followed them to the north, the edges of Siberia. Prehistoric cave drawings, identified as Yukol in origin, first led me to the extraordinary hypothesis that the Yukols had managed to domesticate the mammoth. They are, to the best of our knowledge, the only prehistoric people to represent a man riding a mammoth. Today, because of this genuine mammoth skin effigy, identified by myself as an authentic Neolithic object, I can confirm this hypothesis. Yukol forebears managed to tame mammoths. Prehistoric man uses little imagination. He draws what he sees and represents scenes from real life. This familiar day-to-day object is actually a children's toy. As we have seen, Yukol existence was inextricably linked to that of the mammoth. They used its skin for clothing and to make the roofs and walls of their houses. They used the tusks to build the frameworks of their homes, as well as weapons, tools, and jewelry. Curiously, the disappearance of the mammoth 12,000 years ago had no immediate effect on the Yukol's way of life. It seemed that for a long time after, the people maintained their strong bond with the mammoth through the centuries. As incredible as it may seem, the Yukol people have continued right up until the start of this century to feed themselves on mammoth meat and to use the skin for clothing and shelter. Their ivory craftwork industry is still flourishing. It would appear that to preserve ancestral customs, the Yukols learned how to exploit through the centuries the large number of frozen mammoth carcasses that were perfectly preserved in the ice of the Siberian tundra. They have been able to live mainly off this enormous freezer stock for almost 30 centuries. As plausible as this explanation may seem, it seems it is not enough for the scientific community, who, I will confess, is greatly perplexed by the question. In the absence of acceptable scientific evidence, we have to make do with Yukol shaman artifacts. The research department that I have the honor to represent today lends no credence to the myths and legends that these tribal charlatans peddle. We have to take their stories at face value. Mere tales to while away the long Siberian winter. The legend of the Siberian ice ark is a very good example. You are invited to find out for yourselves from the pamphlet that I had passed around to you. This legend would have us believe that today, somewhere on a lost island to the north of Siberia, there are living mammoths still in existence, a sort of hangover from the ice age. This small herd has been miraculously preserved for more than 120 centuries by the Yukol's tender care. And the island on which the pachyderms are said to live is called Siberia. My friends, I advise you to resist the temptation you may have to believe in this pish and tish. The island of Siberia is not charted on any map, and the idea that mammoths have survived to the 21st century is an idle scientist's pipe dream. The Yukols were sadly among the first victims of the colonization of continental Siberia led by the Russians in the 20th century. The Kolkhoz and Sovkhoz systems, as well as the exploitation, disdain, and humiliation people had to suffer, marked the definitive break in the Yukol's traditional lifestyle. Since the collapse of the communist regime, the Yukol population finds itself confronted with the same political and social upheavals that other Siberian communities are experiencing. There are two consequences to arise from this. Some Yukols have lost their tribal identity and have integrated into the Russian population. Others, however, have sought long and hard to re-establish links with their ancestral culture that was lost under the Soviet regime. Now, at the start of the 21st century, the last true surviving Yukols have gone to live on the vast territories of their ancestors. Nobody knows today where they live or how they survive. Their very existence would be a matter for speculation if they did not turn up periodically at the tundra's most isolated fur trading posts to exchange mammoth tusks for essential items. There ends my lecture for today. Thank you for being among us today, Miss Walker.
대박, 진짜 강의 들으신
Please make your way to the laboratory where you will find your mammoth doll. There are also photocopies of my lecture should you so require them.
조금만 더 가면 돼. 장난 아니다, 진짜. 맵 하나 떠나는데 시간이 엄청 걸려요. 적어도 2시간씩 걸리는 것 같아. 한 맵 떠나는.
Hello?
Where are you?
Hi, Dan. I'm in Bergstadt.
What? Is that a town? I hope the man you're looking for lives there. Are you coming home soon?
From what I gather, it's one huge university with an extraordinary station, aviary. If you could only see it, there are trees and birds everywhere. It's so weird here.
Sounds like a great place for a bit of sightseeing. So, are you coming back soon?
I don't think so. In fact, the train I'm traveling on has some kind of a mechanical problem. We've been forced to stop here.
Us? I thought you were alone. Who's with you?
Oscar, the train engineer.
You're messing around with mechanics now, are you?
Don't be so stupid, Dan, please. Oscar is an automaton created by Mr. Varlberg, the man I'm looking for. And he's not any old robot. He's a sophisticated butler type, if you see what I mean. He's a bit obsessive as well.
Kate, I don't know what they're feeding you in Europe, but don't you think it's time that you came home?
But my mission still isn't finished.
To hell with your mission. I don't know why you accepted it in the first place. If you just stuck to the middle of the road, then we wouldn't be in this mess.
We? If there's any mess, it's me who's in it. And while I'm trying to come to grips with strange towns, you, my darling, are sitting at home on your butt. I seem to remember we had nothing against my departure.
It was only going to be 2 or 3 days, Kate. Please, try to put yourself in my shoes.
Your shoes. Not only do I have to fit myself into your diary, but I've got to get myself into your shoes as well. Is there anywhere else Sir would like me to put myself while we're on the subject?
Look, I don't want to talk about it now. Call me back when you've calmed down.
I was perfectly calm before I picked up your call. I only wanted a few words of encouragement, not your disdain. Was that too much to ask?
You can be such a selfish...
Takes one to know one, sweetheart. Everything okay?
Yes, Kate Walker. I am waiting to continue our journey.
That's it, Oscar. We can go.
Kate Walker, I must remind you of one of the journey regulations. All objects featured in the train's inventory must be replaced before departure.
I don't understand.
Something is missing, Kate Walker.
Oh my God! The mammoth doll!
Please return it to its allocated position, Kate Walker.
I'm off, Oscar. See you later.
Yes, Kate Walker.
Everything okay?
Yes, Kate Walker. I am waiting to continue our journey.
Oscar, if you tell me one more time something's missing, I'll...
Everything is ready. Take your seat, Kate Walker. We are leaving.
I'll... Okay...
깡통새끼 어디 있어 지금?
What are you doing there, Oscar?
It is imperative that we comply with railroad and customs regulations, Kate Walker.
Oscar, don't you think we could drop the trifling details once and for all?
We need an exit visa to get beyond the wall, Kate Walker.
And you wouldn't know where I could get one of them from, would you?
There is usually some form of authority stationed at a guard post that is strategically positioned to issue such a visa.
Oscar, don't you think we've wasted enough time already?
You neglected to find the clockwork winding mechanism for the train with sufficient haste, Kate Walker.
What nerve! And you refused to lend a helping hand. Help that could have been invaluable to me.
I agree, Kate Walker.
If you weren't so obsessed by procedure, we wouldn't have had a hitch.
I am not entirely convinced, Kate Walker.
Oscar, please, let's get in the train and leave, can we?
Yes, Kate Walker. Give me the visa.
비자 주랍니다.
I don't suppose you can help me get this visa, then?
Your non-supposition is correct, Kate Walker.
Okay. See you later, Oscar.
Yes, Kate Walker.
저도 모르겠어요. 지금 미치겠다, 진짜. 아직 엔딩 멀었어요. 한 절반 왔나요, 지금?